Can fun con anemia be cured? We already asked ourselves a single question and in tutorial video, but now we'll go further. We're going to look at both the present and future therapies. To treat aplastic anemia symptoms, periodic blood transfusions from blood banks or blood production stimulation with androgens is needed. However, these are not curative treatments. In fact, the only current cure to treat the hematopoietic problems is a hematopoietic stem cell transplantation. Even though conditions of transplants from alternative donors are improving, the best conditions are achieved when the donor is a sibling. Nevertheless, not all the patients have a sibling or related donor that can donate hematopoietic cells to them. It's for that reason that some families are attempting to give birth to a healthy and compatible baby by preimplantational genetic diagnosis. This baby is often called savior sibling. Whether we like it or not, the success frequency of obtaining and transferring the healthy embryo to the uterus, along with the mother getting pregnant and later giving birth to a baby, is very low. Besides, the hematopoietic stem cell transplantation is not a definitive cure. While it's useful when extending the patient's lifetime, this transplantation is unable to cure non-hematopoietic problems such as their susceptibility of developing solid tumors. Due to the molecular nature of the disease, Fanconi anemia patients are extremely sensitive to chemotherapy and radiotherapy. Hence, it's of particular importance to do a correct follow-up of patients to detect emerging tumors. This includes regular bone marrow aspirations, frequent oral cavity examinations, as well as gynecologic examinations in female patients. It's also a wise choice to give them the human papillomavirus vaccine so as to prevent uterine cancer. And what are the therapies that are currently under development, you might ask? Nowadays, multiple research groups are trying to design what is known as gene therapy. In this therapy, hematopoietic cells would be taken away from the patient and would be then infected by a virus containing the healthy gene. This way, the disease would be corrected by incorporation of the healthy gene, and the corrected cell would be returned to the patient. Although this therapy might seem promising, first tryouts weren't very successful for two reasons. First reason was that infection requires a great number of hematopoietic cells for it to be successful, and patients do not have enough of them. A solution could be cell reprogramming by turning cells easy to recover, such as fibroblasts, into hematopoietic cells, obtaining this way a higher number of cells. The second reason was that the virus used had a low efficiency of infection. Nowadays, this efficiency is reinforced by the use of other viruses, which are called lentivirus. However, the healthy gene could be inserted into an undesired region of the cell DNA, resulting in an undesired cancer. Another more remote therapy would require the use of designed nucleases that would find the mutation and correct it. It would be similar to the reverse mosaicism phenomenon. Not only that, but these nucleases could lead the way to the healthy gene of the previous therapy into a less problematic region of the DNA.